Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Students, in this video I would like to speak to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about 5th chapter. Do you know the name of the chapter? Yes, heat and measurement. Students, in the last 2 virtual video classes, I have invited few students to sit along with me and the classes went through an interaction base. Okay? I hope you all understood that what concepts went through the last videos. Students, in this video I would like to teach you that further points that what we have to discuss. And I would like to recollect the points that what we have discussed in the previous class. Can you recollect them? Yeah. Heat and measurement. What is temperature? And heat is a form of energy. Conversion of heat. And what are the points that we discussed? Thermometer. And there are different types of thermometers as well. Construction of thermometer. Uses of thermometer, types of thermometer, and also I explained about how to use thermometer as well. Students, and also we have talked about expansion of liquids due to heat and properties of mercury and alcohol. What are mercury and alcohol? They are very good conductors of heat. They are used in thermometers. Okay, they can expand with the changes of temperatures. We have talked about mercury and its properties and alcohol and its properties. Students, in this video I would like to explain about if a glass stem of a thermometer is without markings. If you want to mark, how can you create markings on the glass stem? Which glass stem? Plain glass stem of a thermometer. Okay, I would like to explain that in this virtual video class, students. Students, if you want to understand how to create markings on a plain glass stem of a thermometer, you have to follow an experiment. See, students, how to do that experiment? First of all, you should write aim of the experiment. To create marking lines on glass stem of thermometer. Okay, what are the operators to be taken? You have to take, first you have to take thermometer without markings. What? Without marking lines. Next, eyes and beaker. Here you may have a doubt. Here thermometer without markings you have to take, but the thermometer, which type of thermometer should be taken? Any kind of thermometer you can take, but here basically I would like to take mercury thermometer. Mercury thermometer, in the sense the mercury is present in the thermometer. Mercury is a very good conductor of heat, and it's opaque and shine. It cannot stick to the walls of the glass inside the thermometer, the capillary tube of the thermometer. Okay, and these are the properties that we have already discussed. That is not the point here. We have to take a thermometer which is with mercury inside it. Okay, that's mercury thermometer. Now, how you have to do the experiment? How you have to do? Students, first aim you should write, operators you should write, and then procedure. What you should write? Procedure. First point in the procedure you should write like this. You know what you have to do? You have to take ice cubes in a beaker, ice cubes in a beaker, and glass bulb of the thermometer should be dipped in the ice cubes in the beaker. Here I will show. Take a beaker like this. Take ice cubes in the beaker. Okay, right. Now what you have to take? What is this? Thermometer. There are no markings on the glass stem. You can see here. There are no markings here. That you have to create. That is the aim of this experiment. To create marking lines on glass stem of thermometer. Here you have to create markings. And while doing it so, have to keep the glass bulb inside the ice first of all. And you know, it's already with some chemical inside it, right? What is that? What is that? Mercury. So as soon as you keep it in the ice cubes, you know, the level which is there already, the mercury level which is already there in the glass stem, you can see slowly setting it at a particular point. It sets at a particular point. That may set here or here, 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 somewhere else, wherever it is setting. You just mark with a different color like that. For example, it is setting here. Okay. The level of mercury is set here. The level of mercury is setting at a particular point. This point is marked with different color like this. Okay. What next? You have to keep the thermometer same like this, and you have to what? Can you understand what is this? You have to boil it. And before boiling, you have to mark this with zero. This is zero mark. And before boiling, students, you will see it is set at a particular point without changing its level. That remains in the same place, and that is marked with zero. So this zero is nothing but 0 degrees Celsius. You just mark like 0 degrees Celsius. And after marking it as 0 degrees Celsius, you have to boil. Yeah, now it is boiling. And after you keep on boiling, what happens to ice cubes there? Will they remain like same like ice cubes, or else that becomes like water? Yes, ice cubes become like water. Yes. And what about the level of mercury inside the thermometer? Will that remain at the same fixed place, or else as you keep on boiling it, will change its level inside the thermometer? Obviously, it changes its level inside the thermometer, right? The level of mercury will change in the thermometer like this as you keep on boiling. As you keep on boiling, what happens? The level of mercury will change. And as you go on boiling like this, what happens? That ice becomes water and water becomes vapor. You know, after some time, the water gives bubbles, bubbling sound, boils. You know, as it is boiling, and you will see the level of the mercury in the thermometer setting at a particular point, here or here or somewhere else, wherever it sets, you just observe that and mark there also like this. And after it sets at a particular level, you have to mark as 100. This is nothing but 100 degrees Celsius. So, as it is boiling, you know, there will no more ice cubes, right? That will be boiling water as it is boiling, right? You will see some fumes also coming out. Students, this is 0 degree Celsius and this is 100 degree Celsius. Now what you have to do is, you have to take the thermometer out and you have to draw 100 equal distant lines here like this. You have to draw lines. The gap between each line should be equal. Okay? The gap between two lines should be equal. Then, how many lines you should draw like this? 0 to 100. So, how many lines are there on the thermometer now? 0 to 100 equal marking lines. Okay. 0 to 100 equal marking lines are there on the thermometer right now. And then, what do you say this 0 degree Celsius? As it is slowly melting at this point of level of mercury in the thermometer, you can say this is melting point. And here, as the water is boiling, you know, the level of the mercury in the thermometer will not change it at that particular point. That remains at a particular point. That point is called boiling point. Students, what is melting point and what is boiling point of water? So what is the material you are taking here? What is this? Water, ice. The forms of water, you know that? Ice, water and vapor, right? See, students, Basically, we can say it's water, even it is in ice form or else in water form or else in vapor form. We can say it's water, right? And as it is in solid state, you know, when the level of mercury is at a particular point, that point is called melting point. And as it is boiling, you know, the level of mercury will no more change here. That remains at a particular point. That point is called boiling point. So, after you mark 0 and 100, in between these two lines, including 0 and 100, you have to make sure to draw equal marking lines. 100 equal marking lines. 0 to 100 equal marking lines. Okay, and the distance should be equal in between two lines. And distance should be equal in between two lines. Students, the distance between two lines should be equal. Each two lines, 0 to 100. What is the melting point of water now? 0 degree Celsius. And what is the boiling point of water? 100 degree Celsius. And here you may have a doubt. Is the melting and boiling points the same for all the materials in the nature? Or all other liquids in the nature? No, right? No. So, melting and boiling points are different for different liquids in the nature. But why should we take water only here to give marking lines on the plain glass stem? Because water is a universal solvent. Okay, water is what? It's a universal solvent. Got it? What is universal solvent? Because, you know, universal solvent is a solvent which can dissolve many other substances in it, many other liquids in it. Okay, so that we can say it is a universal solvent. Water is, you know, its very basic substance in the nature which supports life of all creatures in the nature. Without water, there is no life on the earth, right? So that water is taken as here a basic liquid, you know, universal solvent. So this matter is not given in your textbook. You just for sake of your knowledge, I am teaching you this. You just remember that, okay? And after you complete this procedure, you have to write inference. Inference is the conclusion of this experiment. How do you conclude? Yeah, the thermometer is ready with markings. Ready with marking lines. Okay? Here, you can write like that. The thermometer is ready with marking lines. So, this can be used as thermometer. You know, students, here I said 0 to 100 lines, right? In between two lines, there should be equal distance, I said, right? And again, in this distance, in this gap, in two lines, you can make further very small lines again. You can mark further very small lines between these two lines. Again, you have to make 10 lines between each two lines like this. Okay? And here, and for example, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on till 100. Now, if you take 2 and 3 here, 2 and 3, in between 2 and 3, you make sure to create further 10 more lines. Okay? So what is the difference between 2 and 3?
1.
So this will be the 1 degree Celsius. And what else, what about other things, you know, other further lines are made between these two lines, right? Two numbers, right? And 1 by 10 degrees Celsius can be written like this, okay? Or else 0.1 degrees Celsius can be written like this. Understand? So, this mathematical expressions and all you will study in coming classes, students. But this is how you can create, how a thermometer is given equal markings on the glass stem. Okay, students? And next, you know who invented first thermometer? Galileo, when? 1593. And he used air inside the thermometer instead of mercury or alcohol or any other chemical substance. He used only air. Okay. He used air as a thermometric substance. But nowadays we are using mercury, alcohol, the thermometric substances. And even in very advanced technology, invented other thermometers like digital thermometers. Now we can see in digital thermometers, as this is the corona season, you know, we can say corona season. Wherever you go, you know, any shopping mall or anywhere else, they keep a gun before your forehead, right? That they don't keep the thermometer for 2 minutes and check the level of thermometer, you know, mercury substance inside it like that. It's taking some time, no? Even to save this 2 minutes time, you know, we created or we invented another type of thermometers called digital thermometers. We just see only number on it. You just click here like this, you just keep here like this and click, then you will find the temperature. Got it? Like that, we are technically very well in advance. Okay? And this is how the science has developed. And this is for this video, students. Thank you for listening and thank you one and all.